Star Wars Episode 9 is set to be the final installment of the sequel trilogy and the Skywalker saga by writer and director J.J. Abrams. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, one interesting thing that a lot of people are just very curious about right now has all to do with the character of Luke Skywalker. Now, many fans around the world were very disappointed with how the character was used in The Last Jedi, and many, including myself right now, are just crossing their fingers of exactly how J.J. Abrams is going to actually treat the character in Star Wars Episode 9, whether that's in the form of a Force ghost, a vision, and or a flashback, or maybe something else new entirely. Now, looking at everything here, you guys may or may not have heard about this. A couple of weeks ago, we heard about this lightly, that George Lucas would be involved in Star Wars Episode 9 during the new year, next year, 2019, during the month of January. And what's really interesting about all of this, aside from that, is it all has to do with the scene, including Luke Skywalker being portrayed by Mark Hamill, that will be guided by George Lucas himself, the man who created this amazing Star Wars franchise that so many have loved ever since 1977. Now, with that being said, it's said that George Lucas will actually only be directing one scene for Star Wars Episode 9, and that he will be delivering a Luke that we have never seen before in one sequence in this movie. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that is one thing to truly look forward to, is seeing a Luke Skywalker that we have never seen before, not in the form, of course, in The Force Awakens and in The Last Jedi, a different Luke in Star Wars Episode 9, at least for a single scene in this film. Now, it's also said that this actual moment will reflect on The Last Jedi and quite possibly even fix certain elements of the character of Luke Skywalker. And that's one other thing that a lot of people are starting to wonder about. Could this be in the form of a flashback? I would like to say so, because if we're thinking about the character of Luke Skywalker and, you know, Disney, Lucasfilm, JJ and crew, George, delivering a Luke that we have never seen before, aside from him being a Force ghost, that is one thing that I think that they are really trying to pull off right now that'll actually resonate with fans and really reflect on The Last Jedi. I think it all has to do with one of the flashback scenes that we have been talking about. We do know that they are using a lot of de-aging technology in Episode 9, one of which may very well be applied to actor Mark Hamill in order to make him appear younger as a new Luke Skywalker, a younger Luke Skywalker in a CGI form. Now, I don't know about you guys, but is that a good idea if they do go through with those plans, de-aging Mark Hamill for a scene in Star Wars Episode 9? Now, to date, we never got to see a post-return of the Jedi Luke. And what I mean by that is, of course, a Luke Skywalker just a couple of years after the events of Return of the Jedi, where he was still somewhat young, you know, still in his 20s, in his early 30s. And with that being said, I gotta say, if we look at the character of Luke, a lot of people want to learn more about his adventures throughout the galaxy with R2-D2 and Lor San Tekka. We do know that R2-D2 has a log of thousands of missions with Luke Skywalker. Hey, that's a TV show right there, right? How much material they got for that? Aside from that, you know, the fact that George is involved in Episode 9 in some way, shape, or form, even though it is just one scene, which, you know, is kind of like, oh, I wish he was doing more, but at least it's something, right? And he will be delivering a Luke that we have never seen before in the Star Wars franchise out of all the 8 movies so far. So with that being said, guys, I would really love to hear what you have to say about this. You know, what do you feel about George Lucas having a little part in Star Wars Episode 9? Do you think that this is a genuine move by Disney and Lucasfilm? Do you think it's a desperate move in order to get fans back into the theaters and into the seats? Or do you think this is something else? You know, is this George's idea on his own? We have no idea, really. And I think that, you know, when we look at Luke, there are only so many things that you can do in order to deliver a Luke that we have never seen before. Of course, a Force ghost is at the top of the list, right? And if George Lucas truly is going to be working on the Force ghost of Luke Skywalker and how he should be in the form of a ghost, maybe that's what he's actually getting at for this movie that will actually be shown to fans around the world. Now, many out there would also argue that Luke Skywalker doesn't need fixing in the sequel trilogy, and if that's your opinion, that's A-okay. You know, I totally am fine with everybody's opinion here. But in my point of view, I really do feel like the character of Luke does actually need fixing in the sequel trilogy. When I look at Luke in The Last Jedi, I don't really recognize him as the Luke Skywalker that I know. And yes, I know, you know, the common thing that a lot of people say is, well, you know, it is 30-some years later, you know, people change and whatnot, but at the same time, this is a massive franchise, and this is a character in pop culture. Instead of him being so bitter for the whole entire film itself, he could be bitter in the beginning, that would have been fine. But it was the majority of the film where they kept with that cut type of Luke. So, in my point of view at least, I really do feel like Luke needs fixing. What's your take on that? Do you think he needs fixing? Does he not need fixing? I would love to hear about you, you know, and your thoughts about that below in the comments. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.